Now ride with me on this one because this is real. We got Chris Coates here. And you guys know Chris Coates will do anything for anybody, and he does a lot for us. Chris is pretty amazing. I've known him, Dave has known him. I've known him 13 years. He used to call me the damsel in distress. So Chris, about a month ago, came to the farm and told us he was diagnosed with Parkinson's. And I think some of you have noticed and asked, you've seen him, he's shaking, he's got some struggling going on. But I'm gonna tell you right now, Chris is not gonna be a victim of Parkinson's. And I know this. Chris is gonna stand up and stand strong in faith, and Chris is gonna be a testimony of faith. He may not beat Parkinson's, but I guarantee you he can stand strong through Parkinson's, because I know that God will put the Holy Spirit in him. And Chris, I ask you to stand up here. So we're gonna all stand here, and I'd like for everybody to stand. We're gonna pull the power of the Holy Spirit in this room right now, and we're gonna pray for Chris and anyone else that is struggling in a battle. I ask you to stand out in the middle. I ask you to raise your hand, and anyone that is near that person that is raising their hand and they're struggling, all you gotta do is this. All you gotta do is you take your hand and you reach it out and you touch that person. Like I said, he's always helping other people no matter what. So we're gonna reach out. Set that good. That's right. Just reach. If you can't reach Chris, put your hand on the person in front of you. And we're going to call the Holy Spirit in this room right now. I have seen the power of laying on of hands, and I believe it. If you're fighting your own battles, we're going to pull it in. Lord, we ask you to come into this room right now. Lord, we know your presence is here. We know that you feel Chris, and Lord, I know his spirit is filled with you. Lord, we ask you to fill his body with your power and your strength. And Lord, we know Parkinson's is real. We know that your will is going to happen. But Lord, we ask that you protect his faith, you protect his soul, and you protect his family. Lord, give him strength so that he can be a testimony of your faith. Lord, please, in this moment, let everyone feel your power work right through this room, because I know that you are here. Lord, in Isaiah 46:4, you tell us, I have made you, I will carry you, I will sustain you, and I will receive you. Lord, we ask your spirit to fill this room. Touch the hands, the hearts, the minds of each person. We feel pain, emotional and physical. But through you, Lord, we sing praises as your light will remove the darkness and allow us to have freedom, peace, and joy. This will allow healing and a path out of the darkness to eternal light. Lord, I ask your grace and guidance that we may pass this light on to others around us. Lord, we praise you for the amazing family we have surrounding us at this time, each filled with your Holy Spirit. Lord, we believe in your power, your strength. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and through you, we can overcome darkness. We ask your Spirit to move through us. Father, you are all power. You are almighty, our healer, our redeemer. Lord, you are the El Shaddai. We trust in you. Let your light shine. Lord, we ask that the love and grace of Jesus Christ shine like a light of love and grace through us. And Lord, we ask you to please place your blessings all around Chris and his family, as well as each one in this room. In your loving name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I appreciate all of you. I know that the power of the Holy Spirit is strong, and I did not expect that response, and that just shows how strong the power of the Holy Spirit can be. Chris, we're all here for you, man, and I know we're going to get through this all together. So, we're going to, now we got to get ourselves, I told you guys I was going deep. That's amazing. I love our Lord. I love our Lord.
Hey, guys. All I can say is, it's just something that I'm still dealing with, trying to figure it out. Nothing I can do about it, it's here. So I'm just gonna make the best of it. I'm not gonna lay down and give in to it. And over the last 4 months, it's been going on a while. I just couldn't. could have figured out. But over the last 4 months, since we've been here, I missed you guys. So it was good just to be back, you know, this weekend. I was looking forward to this weekend. It's been great just to be back with my shooting family. You know, I've been around you guys now for about 15 years, and your family. And I have my family at home, my blood family and all that, but, you know, that's number one. But you guys are family. That's the cool thing about this club and this shooting family, as we call it. Everybody's always there to help somebody else out. And if I don't tell you, I don't shake your hand, I don't hug your neck, just know that I love all you guys, and I wish everybody the best. And thank y'all. Pam just told me she's going to lift me up in prayer. And she took it about 10 steps further. So, thank you guys, and I love you. Thank you. Nash is done gone.